Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik, and today I'm pleased to introduce you to our latest release, Qlik Sense April 2019. This release contains significant advancements to our multi-cloud capabilities, in addition to new market-leading augmented intelligence features, which further support why we are a leader in the Gartner Magic Quadrant for the 9th year straight. Let's get to it. With the Qlik Sense April 2019 release, we are excited to announce new enhancements to our multi-cloud deployment options, including the ability to create, reload, and consume apps entirely in Qlik's SaaS environment, Qlik Cloud Services. With this release, you can now deliver Qlik Sense Enterprise entirely on Qlik Cloud Services or on Kubernetes environments, in the cloud of your choice. All deployment options also work together as part of a multi-cloud infrastructure, giving you flexibility to change your deployment model over time while leveraging the scalability of the cloud. Also available in Qlik Sense April 2019, we have combined the power of our cognitive and associative engines to surface hidden insights within your data. Our Insight Advisor now offers associative insights, helping people spot the unexpected and explore it further. Because our associative engine identifies the data values that are unrelated to your selections, our cognitive engine can now analyze these unrelated values and bring the most significant insights forward, revealing new discoveries and leading to significant value. When analyzing your data, associative insights can be found in the Selections panel in the upper right. Simply click the Generate Insights button to reveal hidden insights related to your selections and choose what you want to explore further. Our April 2019 releases of Qlik Sense and Qlik View introduces unified licensing to Qlik customers that have adopted Qlik View and Qlik Sense dual-use licensing, or are using both products. A Qlik user can now utilize a single license key to unlock both Qlik View and Qlik Sense, simplifying back-end license management. This release also allows you to link Qlik View applications from Qlik Sense Enterprise on cloud services and Qlik Sense Enterprise on Kubernetes. Finally, Qlik Sense April 2019 introduces two new chart types and a new background layer for the Qlik Sense native map chart. As part of the visualization bundle, we have added a new bullet chart, which is appropriate for tracking goals and showing targets combined with color banding to depict your defined ranges. Bullet charts clearly display your metrics with as little clutter as possible. We have also added a new chart called Bar and Area. This chart is a variant of the standard bar chart, but gives more flexibility when applying labels to stacked bars, showing percentage differences, or showing dimensional values on the bars. Our native map chart now has a new background layer that can use any image as a map background. This is great for floor plans and custom drawings that require GPS coordinates to analyze specific dimensions. This is helpful when used with office layouts, hardware positioning, parking grids, stadium seating, transit routes, and much more. Other improvements include task notifications in Qlik and printing, extended Qlik Big Data Index functionality. We have also released the iOS app Qlik Sense Mobile for BlackBerry, providing both online and offline Qlik Sense capabilities built on top of the BlackBerry Dynamics Secure Mobility Platform. For more information on these and other improvements, please check out our release notes on the Qlik Help and software download sites. Well, that's it for this video. If you want a deeper dive on these highlights with each release, be sure to sign up and subscribe for our Qlik Insider webinar series. The next one is scheduled for May 29th. If you want to be notified when more videos such as this are posted and are viewing from YouTube, click the bell icon below. We want to hear from you, so tell us in the comments below what you think. And don't forget to check out these other great resources to learn more about Qlik and Qlik Sense. And please remember to join the conversation with myself and others in the Qlik community. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video. Take care.